So after Obey, you said you went to Red Reserve together?
Yeah, together. Well, Scarce went first. This is like when we were all like moving out of Obey to Red. And like, it's so weird with Red because Red was like a combination of people from the biggest creators from Obey and Sore Gaming. So it was basically like a merged team of just the biggest creators in one team, right? Because okay, Red was designed as like a... It was designed as like a B team for FaZe, right?
Yeah.
Like, that's the original intent, but it didn't necessarily work out that way, but that was like the goal, you know?
Sorry, go ahead.
I was gonna say, I think I remember it like shutting down. Like, what was the reason for that again?
Dude.
I saw like a tweet about it.
Bro, dude, it's crazy. Like, all right. There's a lot of reasons why it shut down. So I guess the biggest one, let me back up a bit. All right, so we had the Red House, right? And
yeah,
we all lived together.
That.
Yeah.
Was that fun? That was dope, right?
Best time of my life. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's just one of those things with your boys, you get together and, you know,
everyone was pushing each other. Everyone was motivated.
Yeah.
Exactly. Yeah. And the reason why it shut down is because, you know, we reached the point with Red where, you know, we wanted to take it further than just being a YouTube channel, right? So we wanted to get into esports, get a Call of Duty team that would play on like the main stage and everything, you know, because we were in the COD scene. We were known for Black Ops 2. And we wanted to get a COD team that could compete and play against like FaZe, Optic. Because that's, you know, that's dope to go to events and root for your team. So we actually got investors involved. And that was the biggest mistake we could have done at the time, because those investors had really bad intentions and we did not know about it. And it really just sucked because they own majority control of the company.
Can you talk about how that worked? Like,
I could talk about it. Yeah.
Like,
I mean,
percentage wise and how are you able to go into numbers and shit? Like how?
Yeah. As far as funding, there wasn't like a set amount, but they would fund like everything we needed. You know what I mean? Like they would fund the teams, the house, all kinds of things, and they would own 51% of the company. So
fuck.
It's
how do you go?
And, you know,
and who owned it at the time?
I did. And just me. And actually, the guys owned a smaller percentage of it. But since I like led the team, since it's like
inception.
But was that on paper, or was that just like the same as Obey?
No, that was on paper. That this is where contracts started to get involved.
Okay.
How old were you at that time?
I want to say 20. I'm 25 now.
Yeah.
So I think I joined Red when I was 19. Something like that.
So when you joined, for what reason? They hit you up and told you to come like run us?
Yeah, Banks actually was the one.
Really?
I was in college at the time, and Banks got me in a call and he was like, dude, join this team and like run it. And I was like, I don't know. Banks is like a guy that you just don't say no to. You know what I mean? He's just a very intimidating guy, you know? And but he's a nice guy. He's a nice guy.
Yeah,
I like Banks
a
lot. And I mean, cause the thing is, here's the thing that I actually never told anybody, but I actually, while I was in Red, I used to manage the FaZe Clan channel, and Banks actually promised me and Scarce that if me and Scarce can get the FaZe channel to 10 million views a month, that we could join FaZe and as leaders. And we actually did, but we didn't join FaZe. But, you know, it's all good.
Banks,
scammer. It's all good. It's not like that. No hard feelings. I mean, we were barely like at that mark anyway, but I don't know.
10 million views is good, bro.
Yeah, that's good.
Back then, especially, it was 10 to 20 mil
on YouTube right now. You're making a good living, you know what I mean? So the fact that you guys got was it like a passing thing? Like, yeah, you can join FaZe, 10 million, or was it like a
it was kind of just like a he said, she said type of thing, like, you know,
do this.
And yeah, we'll like, you know, I'm not gonna hold them against it, you know, it's not like serious thing.
So you took over Red, and then so what, investors came in and you owned what, 80% of it?
Investors came in and I owned when they came in, because they took 51.
Before that, because like you were making the decisions. I want to know if you're able to dive into like Because people always want to know and understand numbers and how nobody ever talks about them. And now that it's been so long, like.
Yeah, so this is at the time when Scarce already got kicked from Red. I forgot what he did to do that, but FaZe kicked him out for some reason. Rain kicked him out. I forgot what he did. Maybe it was over some dumb tweet or something. I don't remember.
He slept with Rain's girl.
What?
I'm kidding.
Bro, what are you talking about, bro? What? No. Yeah, I don't know, but this is when I had like full control, and we got investors involved. They took 51%. I had, I know the guys had like 15 or 10% like share between each other, and then I had the rest. Honestly, I don't remember. It was such a long time ago, but I know for a fact the investors had 51.
What was the point of failure in that? Like the investors are paying for everything. Like when did you have that? That shiver up your spine, like, fuck, this
before
isn't
that, so, before that, before that, before that question, how much did you sell them that 51% for?
Or it was straight, couple,
yeah, go
it
ahead.
It was a couple hundred thousand. Okay. Like, but the thing is, it wasn't like a finite number. Like, it was the
like
thing,
you said before,
the,
yeah.
Yeah, it was
funding.
It was just funding. Yeah.
How do you just trust people on that idea without having it up front?
Well,
you know what I'm saying? Like, how do you give someone? Were they random or were they known?
No, they weren't known. They had like an org already, and they had a COD team. So that's what it was. So they guaranteed that they would transfer their COD team over to our brand.
Okay.
And it would be like a merger of their esports to our team. That's what the contract was about. My bad.
Don't apologize. There's
over
so
the years,
much
bro.
Shit that happened, bro. That's never been told. Like, this is so cool.
And I'm thinking to myself, like, what could he have said to get them to sell 51%? And like, you guys merging the COD team is like a big thing, because that's what I was gonna say. Like, it, like, from a business standpoint, if the deal is, oh, we're gonna fund everything, but we're also gonna take 51%, that basically means that the people if you were to ask them for anything.
Yeah,
you would need their permission for them to give it to you. You get what I'm saying? And like, that's like the issue.
And that's one of the reasons why we started 1%. But we can get into that later if you want. But
I want to go through the whole timeline of formula.
Yeah,
bro.
I mean, we're a no investor team right now. You know
because,
what I mean?
Like, that's, you're a YouTuber, but you're also like, you've been owners of team. You know what I'm saying? Like, there's a lot more to it.
Of course, yeah. It's crazy. Like, dude, I knew the second that this was not gonna work in Red Reserve because so they wanted a return fast. You know what I mean? That's the problem. Like, they didn't believe
what?
In that.
Like, they're not even putting in money yet. You know what I'm saying?
They're not putting in money. And by the way, dude, the first like few months, we were promised that they would pay for our rent for the house. And the rent was like $2,000 a month. And they just cut that out of the picture like a month into the deal. So that's when I already knew the first red flag, like, what the heck is going on here? And we, like, you know, we were bringing in sponsors. We had Jerky XP, we had G Fuel.
Dude, I would kill for a beef, like, just give me unlimited beef jerky, bro.
Oh yeah,
fuck it, like, I don't need anything else. Just I'll eat it on stream and I'll tell people about it.
Yeah, we had our own flavor and everything. Like, we were bringing in deals for how small we are. Like, we all of us together in the red house had like 500k combined subscribers on YouTube, and like, dude, the second they cut the rent expense, like, that was just like the biggest slap to the face. And you know what's crazy about that too is I actually flew to Sweden. The investors were based in Sweden, and I flew to Sweden for like a board meeting.
Oh, okay.
No, so they flew me out, and they told me that they want to fully cut the house. Like, they just want to get rid of it. And they want to go full esports. And I'm just like sitting there like, bro, this is not what we agreed on. Like,
yeah,
I wanted to be like half content, half esports, kind of how like FaZe was built at the time. Yeah. You know, it was like, it started as a content org, but grew into esports. And that's what I wanted too with Red. But they were just not, they were not feeling it. They were like, these content creators can't bring us money. Like, all this yada yada. And then, dude, and like, bro, I'm a grown man, and like, I'm not really I wouldn't say that I'm the emotional type, but when I was there in Sweden, they like these grown dudes that were like 40, 50, you know, telling me that like my boys and like my house was not worth it. Like, bro, right. I went back to the hotel that night and literally cried, bro. Yeah. Like that messed me up.
For sure. I mean, they just stole your fucking baby, bro.
Yeah. And not only that, they didn't like they shut down the vision of just like how they didn't believe in our success. They didn't believe that we could be successful.
Bro, I've told Edwin, like, there's zero, like, we're not selling fucking, like, we need creative control, bro. No, because that's what happens, bro.
Dude, I'm telling you, I'm very adverse to getting outside money that you don't really, really need. You know what I mean? Like because people start things and immediately try finding investors or try finding venture capitalists and this and that. But then you have to pay the piper. You have a responsibility instead of just being able to focus on your craft and letting it take its time. Because you said that they wanted to return quickly, but like if they wanted to return quickly, that means they inherently did not understand the industry. You know what I mean?
Exactly.
And the other thing about that too is if they're cutting out the content side of it, they really didn't understand the industry, because everyone knows that the content is what gets people in and interested into the competitive side of things. Like competitive shit, it's self-sustaining, but it doesn't really grow. You know what I mean? Like we talked about this a few podcasts ago, how it's really, really like, because, you know, there's kids that play Fortnite competitively and that's all they do. That's all they do.
Yeah.
They're going to have a hard time growing when that shit declines even further. But if you're making good content, if you're funny, if you have, you know what I'm saying, if you have that side, that'll grow you. You know what I mean?
Dude, yeah. What's crazy about that too is I actually had a conversation with Colazo the other day about that. I was like, bro, you're out of all the pros.
Friends with Colazo.
Oh, I'm just kidding, because he's one of the few pros that actually competes in like FNCS, like weeks and all that stuff, and streams it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like,
he's great, bro. He's great.
And I understand the whole, like, I understand why pros don't want to stream their strats. And, you know, I get that too. But,
yeah,
you know, there's a greater benefit to streaming you competing, because, you know, people are gonna find out about you, they're gonna follow you, they're gonna want to watch you play in other tournaments. Like, it's just the way to go, man. Like, if you can compete and stream, do it. Like, why not?
Yeah, 100%. I mean, even if you don't get first place, if you get top 15, top 10, but people actually watched you do that and they can't watch the dude in first place win, like, they're gonna watch you. You know what I mean?
Exactly. Like, yeah.
So they fucked your company up. When did you decide to just leave that? Like, you just walked away, you sold the rest of your shares, what happened?
We just walked away. Like, we didn't even want money for it. We were just so, like, tired of this. Like, we were tired of these people telling, like, they wanted to, like, the Twitter. I was so good at Twitter, bro. Dude. I crafted that Twitter. So
Twitter is
fire,
an art,
bro.
It is an art, bro.
It's a craft, you know what I mean? Yeah. And, like, bro, and they were just tweeting out, like, esports scorecards over and over. Like, I would see, like, 40 of them, and the Twitter just died. Like, it straight up died. Like, and I was telling them, like, guys, make a second Twitter, tweet out, like, spam the scorecards and all that stuff there. Like, no one, like, sponsors don't care. Like, dude, it's fine. Get the impressions up first, and then, like, I don't know, dude. It was just a mess. It was like talking to a wall, and they just weren't receiving back. You know what I mean?
Yeah, you're a 20-year-old idiot.
Dude,
you know, like, they're 50 years old, smart and rich. Get over it.
And sweet, you know? And Swedish as fuck, dude. They are good meatballs. Nah, dude, and that's the thing too. Like, I could, like, imagine, like, when I was younger and I had to talk to, like, older business people, bro, like, they definitely look at you like a fucking cockroach. They're like, dude, like, I'm literally four times older than you. I've experienced four times of your life. Like, you don't know shit. But in reality, if they would have listened to you, maybe shit would have gone well. You know what I mean? Maybe if they made a different scorecard, Twitter, shit wouldn't have died. You know what I mean?
Yeah, but for real. And that's not the first time I've had old people like that try to, like, screw me over, bro. When I first, like, started making money, I had a financial advisor that would literally rob me and my guys. Like, dude, it was
for sure.
Dude, like, it's crazy when you're young. It's so easy to be naive to those things because you trust older people for their experience. And, like, it just sucks, dude. It really sucks when, like, people try to take advantage of you like that. And it happens all the time, even to, like, pro players who, like, sign for nothing to orgs and, you know, get scammed. It sucks. And it happens every day. And, it, you know...